Hey guys, I'm Zachary Gray, and this is the Gulf Salt Marsh Snake.
Oh, here we go. Check this out.
Are you gonna take off?
Okay, here we go. Come here.
Look at this. This is my first Gulf Salt Marsh Snake ever. Look at that. That is awesome. Now this would be a decent sized one, but they do get bigger than this one. What I want to do is I want to move over, kind of over there to where you guys can see the marsh that these guys live in. They have a very specialized habitat. Now if we come over here, these snakes are a really special species because they live only in brackish water. And that means that they're not going to be found in ponds or any kind of freshwater lakes. It means they're going to be found solely in brackish water, the area where basically the Gulf meets the river here in Louisiana. Now what I want to do, let's just kind of settle down right over here. What you see behind me is these guys' natural environment, the marsh. Now marsh and swamp are different. These marshes are basically, it's just grass. That may look like land right there, but it's just basically floating grass. And normally these guys are mostly seen after hurricanes. Gulf salt marsh snakes and marsh snakes are most commonly seen by people after hurricanes. I've only found up until today the salt marsh snake, and when I found him it was after Hurricane Isaac. We were cleaning up around a little marsh area and I saw about four of them, and they were all up in the debris, and these guys get washed out of the marsh during hurricanes, and that's when people most likely see them. But other than that, these guys are a very rare snake to find. A lot of times they're very difficult to study because they don't come out too much, and they're found deep in the marsh, so they could be literally anywhere out in these vast areas, and they're very difficult to find. They're very camouflaged, they're very secluded, and they live in such a wide space, such a very safe space actually, from people, that they're rarely found. Now these guys, habitat is really being destroyed here, especially along Lake Pontchartrain, which is right around where I live. Now Lake Pontchartrain, basically our entire coastline is being wiped out, being destroyed. They're putting concrete and levees everywhere, and they say that they're doing that to preserve the coastline, but what it actually does is it destroys animals' natural habitats. We've got diamondback terrapin turtles and all sorts of different bird species, and these guys, marsh snakes, that live along there, and they can't live there anymore because of the people, what they're doing there, building levees and pouring concrete everywhere. So these guys get wiped out. And these guys get killed all the time because people think that they're a water moccasin, and of course these guys look nothing like a water moccasin. I mean, look, they've got a completely different belly pattern, the striped face, and they are considered a species of water snake. However, they're very different in the fact that they will only be found in brackish water. There's very few snakes in the world that will only live in brackish water. I believe the mangrove snake is a very famous one that only lives in brackish mangroves, which is pretty interesting. Now these guys are piscivorous, means they're going to eat fish, but they'll also eat frogs, they'll also eat crawfish, and I would guess that they also eat fiddler crabs. There's a lot of these brown fiddler crabs everywhere, and I would guess that they would eat those as well. Now this snake is being very calm, hasn't tried to bite me at all. It must on me a little bit, but that's not too big of a deal. Most snakes will do that as a defense mechanism when you pick them up. But this is, even though it's more of a dull colored snake, nothing vibrant about it, this is a very rare species of snake. This is the first one I've ever found. They're a very difficult species to find. The salt marsh snake is a much more common species to find, but even they're very seclusive and rarely seen by people. Now these guys look very similar to ribbon snakes and garter snakes. In fact, that's something that a lot of people would confuse these guys for. But they have a much heavier body and a different shaped head. They really do look distinctly different. Now these guys have a different pattern from the normal salt marsh snakes. The normal salt marsh snakes have a line and then they have this checkered patterning down their back. So they look different. These guys have the full striping all the way down their back. And their belly is the favorite thing for me, really. It kind of looks like the belly of a broad-banded water snake that doesn't have the checkering. It's more like a striped broad-banded belly, which is pretty interesting looking. Now, these guys specialize in catching fish, so they're really good swimmers and they're really good divers. Beautiful snake to find. They're really, really rare, guys. This is the first one I've ever found. And in many areas, really what you'll do is you'll find an area where they live in, but then you won't find many other places where they live. So they'll kind of be stacked up in certain areas. So that means around here, there would be a few Gulf salt marsh snakes, but then you go a couple miles from here and there wouldn't be any. So they're living in little pockets of marsh here. But out in the real marsh, meaning if we were to take a boat out into some deep marsh. That's where these guys would be living, but they would almost be impossible to find because of how camouflaged they are and how much space there would be to cover. So the best time to find these guys and the normal salt marsh snakes is right after a hurricane when they get washed out of the marshes. Gorgeous snake to find. It's a rare one to see out here, so it's really amazing that we got to show you guys this snake. Thank you guys so much for watching this video, and if you did enjoy, definitely leave a like, and I will see you guys next time. All right, let's go let this little guy go.